We feel stressed, low, anxious, or have trouble sleeping. Me, you,
your brother, your mother, your friend, colleague, or your neighbor. Waiting. Wondering. Hoping. Hurting. We think there's nothing to be done. Nothing we can do about it.
But that is so wrong. There are things we can do. From today, there's a new way to help turn things around. Every Mind Matters will show you simple ways to look after your mental health.
It'll get you started with a free online plan designed to help you deal with stress, boost your mood, improve your sleep, and feel more in control.
You're not alone.
You're not alone.
You're not alone.
We're in this together.
We can all benefit from taking simple steps to look after ourselves
and help those around us.
Because good mental health
makes such a difference.
Every mind matters.
So let's do it.
Find your way to better mental health. Search Every Mind Matters to get your personal plan. Let us hold
each other. Come on.
And welcome back to Vox Africa's Mental Health Special on Every Mind Matters campaign. I'm still joined in the studio here by Richard, an actor and mental health awareness activist, as well as Vanessa Boachi, a psychological therapist and mental health awareness activist. So thank you very much for sticking here with me. I wanted to start with you, Vanessa. Obviously, you had experienced some trauma in the past that definitely led to you having difficulty. Let's speak about how you dealt with this and how you helped yourself get back into where you consider better mental health.
So just to tell you a bit more about what happened in my first encounter with mental health anyway. So I was around 17 at that time, and someone who was quite close to me attempted to end their life in front of me. So I remember this quite vividly. You know, we were near a motorway, and they wanted to actually jump off a bridge. So, you know, when you have the motorway and there's a bridge that goes over, they literally, you know, put their leg over to attempt to end their life.
Obviously luckily, traumatic,
So luckily, through police intervention, you know, there was quite a bit of assistance there anyway. But following from that experience, I did develop anxiety symptoms. And at the time, I didn't know anything about mental health. I didn't understand, you know, what mental health actually is. Again, because I hadn't had that conversation with someone. I hadn't actually, you know, spoken to anyone about it. So, you know, I started noticing a few symptoms. Like heart palpitations, shaking, you know, stomach cramps, all of those things, which initially at that time I thought I had a physical health condition. So I remember actually calling 111 to explain my symptoms. And, you know, they said that there was nothing wrong with me. So I went in for a check-in, and you know, the GP said that it's anxiety related. So that was my first ever encounter. And in terms of managing it, I started doing the research myself. So I'm a very proactive person. If I know that there's something wrong, I want to try and fix it. So did a bit of research online to see, you know, what it was about, look at how I can help myself. And I met someone who was a mental health professional, and this was at an event, and they were talking to me a bit more about what they do. This was, again, a Black therapist, and that itself for me was quite inspiring. Wow. To see, you know, that there's actually Black therapists out there, because at that time I hadn't actually come across that. So yeah, she started coaching me and started helping me with my symptoms, and that is what inspired me to actually go into the profession itself as well. So I was doing things such as like deep breathing, thought challenging, so reconstructing my thoughts with different things as well, worry management, all of those different techniques to help me manage what was going on. But that was through the support of, you know, that person that I met, who's now my mentor actually as well.
That's fantastic. Richard, I'd like to go to you. Being an actor is one of probably one of the most exciting as well as challenging careers currently now, because it's a very thought-provoking career. You have to take on different scripts, you're waiting that telephone to ring, so there are different parts that you have to deal with there. How did you, you know, manage to help yourself through what you went through as a young teenager at the time, and now coping with the business that you're in, that's very kind of like emotion driven, you're waiting for telephone calls from agents, scripts to come through. Did I get that role? Didn't I get it? I hope I'll be good tomorrow. Yeah. How do you manage yourself through this?
To be honest, back then was terribly hard. Where it was so long ago, I didn't have the tools that are now available to everyone. So I had to really get to know myself. Now, I weren't in a position to even really seek help from my friends until later. And I remember trying to keep myself busy. The people that were around me, where they didn't really know me, they just were sympathetic. And it was everything, every little bit helped. So I appreciate it. But it would have been nice to hear from my community and actually have the community around me. Because I remember hearing a saying once, it's not just your parents that raised you,
it's the village.
I didn't have the village around me, so I had to do everything for myself. And now that I look back and the field that I'm in now, it made me, it hardened me to a certain extent where I have thick skin. So in terms of acting, if I don't get a part, I don't sit and wallow about it. It's done. It's over. I accept, and a big thing is acceptance. You have to get over stuff very, very quickly. So I remember keeping myself busy and constantly just, I weren't meditating at the time, but I was thinking about better times ahead. And obviously in this day and age, again, if I don't get a part, I know there's gonna be many other parts out there. I might go for 50 parts, get one. That's just the nature of the business, the nature of the beast.
But you have to be aware of that.
Yes, of course. But again, back then, it was hard. It was very, very hard. But it might sound strange, but I kind of appreciate the stuff that I've gone through, because it's made me the person I am today. So now I'm just mentally strong. There's nothing that can dead my soul, my spirit, nothing. So I have to just keep going. And I just believe that, you know, everything happens for a reason. But, you know, in terms of mentality, you have to, what works for you might not work for someone else.
Yes.
So you have to try different things, but you have to be patient as well. So, you know, I'm kind of happy stuff worked out the way it did.
Yeah.
Now I'm here trying to spread this message and trying to help people all over the world if I can.
Absolutely. Now we've seen in one of the other conversations that's been had in the Black and ethnic minority, you know, communities, is the fact that the waiting times at, you know, seeking assistance or getting help or seeing a, you know, a professional at the, you know, has always been kind of one that people have continuously spoken about in recent times. However, you know, organizations like Every Man Matters and the NHS is currently really, really pushing not only for the general public, but also within the community to really come out and seek assistance. Now, Inside Out is your organization. What exactly, or how do you reach out to people to also use these tools that Every Mind Matters has, and also try to seek assistance with psychological therapists like yourself?
Yeah, so, you know, you're completely right in saying that the waiting times are ridiculous. It depends on where you are in the UK. Literally, it's a postcode lottery, unfortunately. So, you know, the NHS is a great system, but at the same time, it's under a lot of pressure. And that's something that, you know, through working within the NHS, I have seen firsthand. And even in the private sector as well, where I've done a bit of work, that I've seen that there is a lot of pressure. One thing that I noticed was that there's a lot of emphasis on seeking support when people are in the severe state. So, you know, there's a lot of symptom treating as opposed to healthcare itself. And that's the reason why I set up Inside Out UK. So the purpose of that is to provide mental health education. So I'm a strong believer that prevention is better than cure, and early interventions is of course much better as well. So giving people those practical tools and techniques that they can use, you know, at any point of their lives. You don't have to be going through a mental health condition, because everyone experiences life challenges. That's just facts. That just happens. But the difference between someone thriving and someone surviving as well is, you know, that empowerment. So, you know, my aim with Inside Out is to empower people with these practical tools, you know, to face depression, low mood, you know, sleep deprivation, anxiety, even things like financial wellness, because that's something that affects
absolutely
our community a lot. And
people are thinking about the bills, they're thinking about income.
And we're not having that conversation as well. And I think also looking at health in a holistic way. So it's not just about, you know, what you're looking at. It's not just about, you know, for instance, fitness. It's also about what you're feeding into your mind. It's also about what you're eating. It's also about your interactions, looking at it in a more 360 approach. And that's what I aim to do with Inside Out. So we do monthly workshops based on different topics. So in January we looked at low mood and breaking the cycle of procrastination. February we looked at anxiety, and the workshop that we've got in March is about financial wellness, so improving that financial wellness. And we work and collaborate with different organizations and different people. So for instance, with the financial wellness one, we're looking at the psychological aspects and the impacts there, but we also have a finance guru, a money mentor, who is actually coming in to teach people about how to, you know, improve their savings, credit scores, things like that, which is all part of well-being, which I think is really important anyway. So the, you know, the emphasis is on giving people the tools and techniques
to deal with that. So where can I sign up?
So you've got a website. The website is www.insideout.org.co.uk. All the information is there about all our workshops, all of our events. We're also on social media. So it's insideout_UK on Instagram, Twitter. We're there. YouTube.
Just go and check it out. And finally, just to go back to the quiz on Every Mind Matters, that it's just a five-question quiz, isn't it? And what exactly does it look? Does that quiz look? How does it help, or what goes on after the quiz, basically?
So with the quiz, as you mentioned, there's five questions. You answer those questions, and they're really simplified as well. So it's not using any psychological jargon that will confuse anyone.
Everyday
language that is quite easy to understand. And then following from the quiz, you'll be given a plan. So with that plan, it will just give you different techniques that you can use. It can be helpful for if you're, you know, going through anxiety, low mood, sleep deprivation, stress, all of those different tools, you know, to help you with those things. And the great thing about the mind plan as well is that if you find that there's something that maybe doesn't work for you, then you can, you know, refresh it and then get a different
one.
Different options, different solutions as well. So there's something there for everyone, as a really good first point of contact.
Well, thank you very much for that, Vanessa. And thank you for joining us here on Vox Africa UK. The information is below if you want to check out the websites, either the websites that Vanessa or Every Mind Matters has put up. Please make sure you go on it, onto it. I'm Aisha Olajide, and thanks to Richard and Vanessa for joining me. Until next time, it's bye for now.
You're not alone.
You're not alone.
You're not alone.
We're in this together.
We can all benefit from taking simple steps to look after ourselves
and help those around us.
Because good mental health
makes such a difference.
Every mind matters.
So let's do it.
Find your way to better mental health. Search Every Mind Matters to get your personal plan. Let us go.